What are NFTs? This is a new question, much talked about and discussed these particularly among innovative entrepreneurs and crypto lovers. This term has also quickly become the point of attention of common man, carefully observing the new discoveries and innovations happening around. Before I start telling you what NFT is, do not forget to like, share, and subscribe our channel, the non-fungible contents. An NFT, non-fungible token, is data added to a file that creates a unique signature. It can be an image file, a song, a tweet, a text posted on a website, a physical item, and various other digital formats. This basically means that someone can own a digital file, and that it's marked with code to differentiate it from any digital replicas. NFT Digital Art. An NFT is also a digital asset that exists completely in the digital universe. You can't touch it, but you can own it. An NFT can be any type of digital file, an artwork, an article, music, or even a meme such as Disaster Girl, the original photo of it sold for $500,000 earlier this year. NFT art examples include a picture of Mona Lisa NFT that is slightly misleading as the Mona Lisa wasn't originally a digital artwork. It's a physical painting, of which only one exists. There are numerous ways to confirm its authenticity. Most pieces of NFT art will be digital from their inception. As in, they're not digital representations of something physical, but digital alone. Normally, this means that it can be nigh on impossible to prove you have the original artwork, as each copy is essentially identical. NFTs try to solve this problem. One such digital artwork is BEEPLE's Every Days, the first 5,000 days. It is the most expensive NFT to date, selling for $69,346,250 or £50,673,182 in March 2021. In this specific instance, the man who bought this BEEPLE NFT, Vignesh Sundarasan, known by his username MetaCoven, received a digital file of the artwork and is allowed to display the Every Days digitally. However, Sundarasan does not own the copyright. He also wouldn't be able to present the image of Every Days being hosted anywhere else on the internet. He can simply say he has the certificate of ownership to prove what he owns is authentically the original artwork. In other words, bragging rights. NFT art has perhaps also challenged the notions of what an artwork can be. Memes such as Disaster Girl and Success Kit or viral media such as Charlie Bit My Finger have been sold for thousands of dollars. By turning cultural ephemera into purchasable items, the NFT process has commodified a previously intangible section of internet culture, and in the eyes of the market, potentially canonized those items as art. How to make money with non-fungible tokens? From celebrities to respected companies, everyone is talking about launching their own NFTs. But not all NFTs are made equal. While some are worth a fortune, some can be worthless. Opinions expressed by entrepreneur contributors are their own. There's no doubt that non-fungible tokens are the most popular trend in the crypto community right now. From celebrities to respected companies, everyone is talking about launching their own NFTs, but not all NFTs are made equal. While some are worth a fortune, some can be practically worthless. Let's take a look at some of the most profitable ways individuals and companies are making money during the current NFT gold rush. Number 1. Digital works of art. When it comes to sheer profitability, individual NFT artworks are by far the most valuable non-fungible tokens ever created. On March 11th, the history of blockchain technology and the history of art changed forever. CHRISTIE'S, one of the most renowned auction houses in the world, sold an NFT work of art for $69 million. It was the first time when CHRISTIE'S auctioned a fully digital artwork. The piece entitled Every Days, the First 5,000 Days, was created by a digital artist Mike Winkleman, better known as BEEPLE. The NFT is not a single artwork but a collage of 5,000 tokenized images which BEEPLE was creating every day over the course of years. While some people are already raising concerns that selling what is essentially a link to a picture for millions of dollars could be just a front for money laundering, others believe that NFTs are a true revolution in the world of art. The record-breaking price set by BEEPLE's NFT may soon be surpassed. After all, BEEPLE was, until very recently, a completely unknown artist. If someone like Banksy decides to auction an NFT work of art, the price would much likely be higher than $69 million. Number 2. Licensed collectibles. Tokenizing collectibles seems like the most natural and obvious application of the non-fungible token technology. The brands which were already selling physical collectibles such as trading cards can now also sell the same thing in a digital form. Since NFTs have provable rarity, the price of a digital trading card can be much higher than the price of its physical counterpart. Number 3. NFT video games. The NFT-based video games could very well be the future of NFT technology. So far, none of the games utilizing non-fungible tokens managed to gain widespread popularity, but the potential of applying NFTs to video games seems tremendous. Gamers are already known to spend fortunes on virtual items, World of Warcraft gold, Call of Duty loot boxes, or Counter-Strike skins. All of these markets are already worth billions. If any major video game company decides to sell in-game items as NFTs, the impact of such a decision on both gaming and blockchain ecosystems would be tremendous. It's also worth noting that NFT video game developers are among the most ambitious non-fungible token creators, and NFT in-game items might push the evolution of non-fungible technology forward. Compared to simple digital trading cards, or even to more interactive NFTs like virtual works of art, in-game NFTs are by far the most advanced. Non-fungible tokens utilized in video games can be very complex, fully interactive, and they can change over time, for example by being upgraded or by leveling up along with the player's character. The NFT gold rush. Here's why everyone is talking about non-fungible tokens. Non-fungible future. Non-fungible tokens are much more than just another quickly passing crypto trend. The NFT technology has many unique applications, and the full potential of NFTs is only beginning to be explored. It seems like the NFT gold rush is only starting as more and more individuals and businesses decide to enter the non-fungible token ecosystem. The fact that the most popular NFTs are still simple images suggests that the market is still very undervalued. The true eruption in NFT popularity might not begin until complex non-fungible tokens exploring the full potential of the new technology become more popular. Fungible tokens are the first step to integrating individual ownership with digital assets, non-fungible assets. A non-fungible token is a digital item that can be created, minted, sold, or purchased on an open market, and owned and controlled by any individual user, without the permission or support from any centralized company. The information is apt for everyone from a beginner in this space to a professional who is already aware of the nits and grits of the NFT world. Before diving deep and talk about more such topics in future, I would like you to subscribe, like, and share our channel, the non-fungible contents, and then take a moment to ask a question to yourself. Why am I here to learn about NFT? The answer to this question can be anything such as, I'm an artist looking for a marketplace where my art can be appreciated by a wider audience. Or, I'm a crypto enthusiast will determine your takeaways from this guide. Pick your reason as this guide will justify your research needs just right. I ensure that once you go through all our videos, you will be fully equipped to take steps towards your purpose of being in this space.